Coming up in this video, I'm going to react to Wales' 1-0 defeat to Hungary in Hungary. And also, I'm going to go on a rant about us being linked with Wan-Bissaka and Harry Maguire. The thought of it makes me physically sick. But first is first. Gareth Bale has to take full responsibility for our defeat tonight. Just what the hell was he thinking? It was a great ball across the face of goal. He scuffs his shot, and in that, he tries to chip the Hungarian goalkeeper. He should just put it in the right corner or the left corner. He channeled his inner Mesut Ozil tonight. That should have been food and drink for a player of Gareth Bale's ability. He stanked the place out, and now he has to make a decision. Does he continue to stay in the Madrid sunshine? Or does he get his hunger back, no pun intended, and move to another club, get first team football, rebuild his career again, and go from there? The ball's in your court, Gareth. It's your choice. As Del Boy would say, is your money, is your choice. So there you go. But the only crumb of comforts I can muster up after our defeat. One, we've got those two away games against Hungary and Croatia out of the way. Two, we've got more points in our group than the dirty Danes have in theirs. Just wanted to point you out to those Danes who may or may not be watching right now. Anyway, we carry on. And we missed so many chances. And obviously creating chances is fantastic. But we had great chances against the dirty Danes at their place. We had a great against Croatia, who were also dirty in that game. And against Hungary. But we didn't take them. And if you don't take your chances, you're in trouble. And Hungary actually played the game as it's supposed to be played. Accordingly. No bad tackles. No frills. No spills. No heated arguments. No trying to wind up and dive all over the place. They were model professionals. And that is how you do it, Croatia and Denmark. You don't need the dark arts to win football matches. Because Hungary have got talent and they've got players that don't do, we're going to ruffle the opposition's feathers here. We're going to beat them by skill, determination and all the great players we have at our disposal. And they've changed their coach as well, by the way, so that does also help. So there'll be questions for Gareth Bale. There'll be questions for Ryan Giggs. But I don't think you can blame him for what's gone on. We just need to take our chances. Shooting practice on the training ground tomorrow would be beneficial and ideal. So that you can get, you know, the attacking philosophy under their spell. Now on to the rant regarding Wan-Bissaka and Maguire. Christ, I thought the banter era was over with. But no, it's still here, alive and well. I would rather keep Ashley Young than buy Wan-Bissaka, or as I like to call him, Wan-Bissaka. That's what I call him. I don't even think we're in for him. What, Sky News, Sports News, do you think they have credibility anymore? That ship sailed years and years and years ago. I think it's fake news, I do. I think it's just put Man United in the ethos to encourage Man City and to scare them into paying the required fee to get Wan-Bissaka, be it by Crystal Palace themselves or Wan-Bissaka's entourage. I don't think we're in for him, and I hope Man City get him. The same with Maguire. They're welcome to Maguire, and they're also obviously welcome to Wan-Bissaka. And what we're going to do, kick the low out onto the curb. That's not unfair on him, is it? I mean, we bought him last summer. What's he going to think right now? United are apparently in for Wan-Bissaka. Deleau will be a better right back in the future than Wan-Bissaka will be. He is overrated. And don't give me this rubbish that you've watched him play every single week. Most of you just watch YouTube compilations. And as I said before, when we signed Fred, they only show the good bits. They don't show the bad bits. They should show a combination of them both. So you can't say how good a player is via that. Now, for Daniel James, who's just signed, you can, because the two games he's played and he did what he did. And it's not Ashley Young's fault that he should be playing at left back instead of a right back. But unfortunately, Mr. Blobby, aka Luke Shaw, who's apparently pregnant, isn't he? How did he manage that, getting pregnant? I bet his girlfriend's a little bit bamboozled by that. Anyway, he's also got dirt on Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, surely. He's surely got some, you know, some dirt on him. You know, and Ashley Young got to a semi-final for England at left-back as well, by the way. Just to let you know that as well. And Luke Shaw wasn't called up to the latest squad because Gareth Southgate has eyes. And Harry Maguire, another player. Why are we going for him? He is ban average. The only reason our supporters want him is because these top Reds, once again, surprise, surprise, Cilla Black, want you to go, oh yeah, we're in for Maguire. They brainwash you again. It's like a religious cult. It's like a colonage, isn't it? Top Reds jump and you lot say how bloody high. Oh, because Maguire got to a semi-final. They faced bloody farmers. One of which was Panama. One of the worst teams in World Cup history. Akindled to Yugoslavia. That's how bad they were, Panama. Like they were brother and sister together. Two peas in the pod. Go and get Adeviereld. 25 million. That's a bloody snip. He's better than all our centre-backs put together. Chris Smalling is a better centre-back than Maguire. Phil Jones also. So is Bailly. So is Lindelof, even though I don't rate Lindelof. I think he's ban average. And Rojo, on his day, is better than Maguire. But Adeviereld kicks them all to the curb. So, I'll say this now on camera. If we sign both Wan-Bissaka and Harry Maguire, Ole Gunnar Solskjaer will be sacked. That'll be the catalyst for that. Others will say, well, if Matic plays every single week, or Ashley Young plays, that will apply. But I'm telling you now, these two signing, Ole will be out the door. He won't survive Christmas. And do you know what? He'll bloody deserve not to survive. He's already in hot water with me over his treatment of Marouane Fellaini. There was no need to sell him. And until we finish second, or until somebody else from the squad does what Fellaini did, scoring all those winners and all those goals to win us all those trophies post Sykes Ferguson, then getting rid of him was the wrong decision. And that is a fact. You know? Ricardo Pereira is a better right back than Wan-Bissaka, and he also scored against Leicester City. You know? Thomas Meunier, get him for PSG. He's a better right back than Wan-Bissaka. We've only got two right backs so far. You can't have third, because Ashley Young's not going anywhere. And I think Dolo deserves to keep his place. He shouldn't be out the door. He doesn't deserve it. And he shouldn't be playing in a position he's not familiar to. You can't play him on the bloody wing. You got winners for those positions. Round pegs and round holes. Square pegs and round holes. That's what this is about. It's ludicrous. All he needs to get buck his ideas up and start thinking and acting like a Man United manager. Because if you don't, you won't last very long. And history, as I said before, Van Gaal will repeat itself and you will get the heave-ho just like he did. If you think playing young players is going to win us the league or win us any trophies, you forget about it because it won't happen. I guarantee you it won't.